Hello people, welcome to this video. Let's see together how to use ZBrush for release 7. Very simply and easily. Leave us comments to improve our future videos. ZBrush is a software used for 3D modeling and sculpting. We will see how to use its basic features. You may need more practice to create very good models. Let's see the basic workspace. We use here the Compact User Interface, UI. You can switch the workspace in the top right corner. On top you have the different menus that contain all features this software has. On the left you have some quick tools used for drawing. On the center you have your main canvas, where you build your project. On the right you have the palettes open. If you hold Ctrl down on the tools and buttons, ZBrush shows you some notes that can really help you when starting. When opening a menu, if you click on the icon on the left, you open the menu as a palette on the right, ready to use anytime. You can open and close palettes clicking on their respective titles and move through them, dragging up and down on the extreme right. Click again on the icon to close any palette. When you open ZBrush, a smart navigator called Lightbox is open. This shows all projects, brushes and textures saved inside the ZBrush installation folder. ZBrush shows the content of the installation folder, project, all projects saved inside, and so on with the other sections. You can open and close this navigator clicking on Lightbox in the top left corner. If you close it, you will show your new empty canvas where you can start drawing in. Before going on, it is very important to understand how this software manages what you build. On the topmost level, you have the ZBrush project, that is your work in full, complete, with all its objects and brushes inside. This project is then composed by different objects, called tools. Then each tool can be edited and personalized with brushes, textures and colors. Save and fix your new project. Go to File and then to Save As. ZBrush projects are saved as .zpr files. In case you save outside the ZBrush folder, a link is created, so there you can find all your projects under Project section. Once your project is defined, use Ctrl and S to save fast. To build your project and its objects, you need to use the tools. Basically, you have the 3D tools and the 2.5D tools. The first ones do show simple basic solids or more complex shapes, like animals or humans. The 2.5D tools are simple plain brushes, and all the other tools to edit existing drawings or 3D objects. You can open and close the tool clicking on the biggest image inside the tool palette. This palette shows you all the latest tools you have used your project open. You can select and use others going under Tools section in the Lightbox. To draw in two dimensions, you can use the simple brush tool. Just click and drag. On the extreme left, choose the stroke style. That changes the way to draw your brush. Then you can change alpha, which changes the shape of your brush. Textures applies a texture on your brush. More below, you have the colors. Click inside to choose it. You can choose in draw sides the size of your brush. Very important is to understand what you are drawing. These simple brushes are made of pixels, geometrical shapes that do have a position, an orientation, a color, and a material defined. The material defined is described on the left, in the matcap section. On top, choose to brush using a color plus a material, with mRGB enabled. Using just the color, using RGB, and using just the material, with M. Plus, you can increase the color opacity, increasing the RGB intensity. Whenever you create a single brush, a 2.5D object is created, all in one piece. On top, you can use the Move, Scale, and Rotate to edit this brush down. A cross system appears on such a drawing. The red segment represents the Y direction. If you click and drag from the purple side, you will move or scale just from up to down or vice versa. The green one sets the X direction. If you drag from the light blue side, you will move or scale from the left to right or the contrary. If you move or scale from inside, you will move anywhere or scale respecting the aspect ratio. The rotate tool uses this system as well. If you drag from the blue circumference, you will rotate in 2D only. But if you drag from the internal area, you will rotate in full 3D. You can draw again clicking on Draw on top. However, if you draw something else, you can't select your previous brush again to edit it. Keep this in mind. If you mistake and want to go back, you can use Ctrl and Z. To delete any brush on the canvas, you can use the eraser brush in the 2.5D brushes list. Not all the brushes are the same. Depending on the tool you choose, you can draw a new brush or edit an existing one. For example, try the smudge tool or the tools dedicated to contrast and saturation. Check your canvas often using the visualization buttons on the right. Drag from the scroll button to pan and check your project. Use the plus and the minus key of your keyboard or drag from the zoom button to zoom in and out. Then you have the 3D tools or objects that do cover all three dimensions. From the tools palette, choose one of the shapes below 3D meshes, then simply click and drag on the canvas to set the sides. These 3D meshes are called 3D primitive solids and are basic shapes saved inside ZBrush, used to start from to make personalized 3D shapes. Basically, it is better to start from a 3D sphere. Other objects, like the cube or the cylinder, have fewer points, and editing them may be quite harder. But if you have to work on complex shapes, like humans or animals, you can start from the 3D tools inside Tools section in Lightbox. To start editing the shape, click on Edit on top. This enables all 3D features ZBrush has. On the right, more at the bottom, you can use Move, Scale, and Rotate to view better your project on your canvas. Mind that this does not change the position and the orientation of the object itself. You can rotate fast by clicking and dragging on the vacant canvas spaces. To start sculpting, you can't use the original 3D meshes you had just drawn. You need to convert this 3D solid into a 3D polymesh first. In the tool palette, click on Make Polymesh 3D with the Edit tool enabled. To edit this object, you need to use the 3D brushes, the first feature on the extreme left. There are plenty of 3D brushes, all made to create your shape. We won't see all of them, but let's see some fundamental tools you need to know. There is a group of tools dedicated to change the tool's surface, like blob, clay, and so on. All of them are recognized through a simple sphere with a different kind of surface. Simply click and drag on your object. Then you have the clip brushes, used to make conductors starting from the object you have. As ZBrush suggests, hold Ctrl and Shift down to define the section of the conductor first. Some other tools do smooth the object surface, like planar, or are able to create a plane surface, like flatten. Other tools, like displace curve, wants you to trace a line that you will drag on the object surface to create curves or deform. Remember the history bar on top. If you drag it on the left, you go backwards on your previous actions done. As seen for the 2.5D tools, you can set the draw sides on top. But in this 3D case, the Z intensity regulates the harshness of the brush you are applying. Also, the pointer is a little more complex, red, with an inclination dependent on the surface you are hovering. On the left, you have the same options for the 2.5D tools. Decide the material, the color, the stroke, and the shape of your current editing brush through Alpha. The Move, Scale, and Rotate buttons on top work quite differently instead. In each of these, click on one object's point. You will get a 3D oriented cross perpendicular to the object's surface on such point and with all the three coordinates. If you use Move, use the central circle to move the object on the canvas. Moreover, one of the external circles cuts off part of the object, while the other one deforms it. If you use the Scale tool, use the external circles to scale without deforming the object. Use the central one to deform according to the direction chosen. If you are using the Rotate tool, you will rotate the object in 3D, respect to the direction chosen. Let's see some quick buttons that can save lots of your time. For example, if you hold Ctrl and your right click down, you can fast zoom in and out the canvas. If you hold Ctrl down and click, you will create a mask, indicated by a dark color. A masked surface is protected from any possible editing or brush, unless you unmask it. You can unmask by holding Ctrl and Alt keys and clicking. If you hold Alt down and click and drag, you will brush on the opposite way. If you hold Ctrl and Shift and click and drag, you create a selection area. This simply saves all the parts of the object that stay within such area, and all the rest is cut. Once your object is done, you can save it going on Save As in the tool palette. Single objects or tools are saved as .ztl files. Differently from ZBrush projects, these tools files can be loaded on different projects, going on Load Tool in the tool palette. Then, each project is made of lots of different tools, all shown below the tool palette. If you don't need one anymore, select it. Go to Subtool and then to Delete. In case you want to save a sort of snapshot of your canvas, you can save it as a document. A document is a project where you can't edit or rotate any of its objects anymore. Documents are saved as .zbr files and can be opened and saved through the document menu. This is all. Check out our channel for more amazing guides.